Hey everyone, welcome to today's video, where we'll be diving into the process of bringing this project to life. Grab a cup of coffee and some cookies, this is going to be a fascinating journey. In crafting this project, my aim was to weave a captivating ambience reminiscing of the late fall mood. Picture the lake house as a haven of warmth and snow comfort amid the seasonal gloom. To capture this essence, I played with chili color tones, intensifying the effect in the later stages of post-processing and color correction. Now, let's shift our focus to the technical facet of the project. Following the completion of the house's geometry, I brought it into the Unreal Engine. Employing conventional tools, I created a simple lakeside landscape. For texturing the landscape, I created an automatic material. Although the structure of the material may look complex, in fact, there are many repeating nodes for each of the landscape layers. Let's explore some techniques to enhance the overall aesthetics for the landscape material. Initially, the material had this appearance. As evident, there is noticeable repetition in the texture. In order to infuse a more natural feel into the material, I incorporated elements such as texture bombing and camera depth fade. These components play a crucial role in minimizing the repetitive texture effect. Now let's draw a comparison between two options. On the left we have the material featuring the texture bombing component, while on the right it's without. Texture bombing dynamically blends the texture in a random sequence, generating a diverse and varied effect. The camera depth fade component smoothly transitions the texture scale based on the camera's position. As the camera moves away from the surface, the texture switches from small to large scale. By the way, for the sake of convenience, I utilized rearward nodes. They assist in organizing and streamlining the structure. This node acts as a portal, redirecting the logic. Dealing with water surface is straightforward. It's a plane with a water material from the engine's default material set. You can locate these preset materials in the engine folder. To create fire in the fireplace and candle flames, I used the free assets from M5 VFX 2 Fire and Flames pack. These are high quality fire, smoke and explosion effects that I really like. Now let's move on to the environment. Firstly, to ensure the clouds have the right appearance, I created several variations of texture mask using Photoshop brushes. The structure of material for clouds and fog. This is the color of the fog. Next is the mask to soften and hide the boundaries of the texture. Color intensity. Then, using linear interpolation, I blended several textures. The panner nodes create a smooth movement effect. The blending of cloud texture occurs through a mask that also has animation. This solution allowed for adding more diversity to the animation. Next, I assign this material to a plane shape and position them in the scene as a background. For lighting, I used a tool from the starter content set, BP Light Studio. I often use it when I need to quickly illuminate a scene using an HDRI map. BP Light Studio is located in the starter content directory under Blueprints. You can add the starter content to a scene at any time. I obtained the Overcast Sky HDRI map from the website with free assets polyhaven.com. To create snow-covered mountains in the background, I opted for the fastest and simplest method. Firstly, I selected several panoramic shots of mountains terrain. Then, in Photoshop, I created a seamless texture. I ended up with two textures. One for the base color and the other as a mask texture. In the material settings for the background, I changed the blending mode to masked, to make the mask slot available. I placed in the scene a geometry of a large diameter flat cylinder and applied the material to it. In my opinion, it turned out quite well. This method of visual illusion does not require significant time investment in generating and texturing relief or searching for suitable assets. To enhance the depth effect and conceal visible landmarks indicating that the background is flat, I configured exponential high fog and added a layer of fog at the water surface. I created this using the same principle as the clouds. To create the sunlight, I used directional light. In the settings, I activated light shaft bloom to add a god ray effect. These are perhaps the main and most interesting technical features of this project. I completed the final assembly and post-processing of the video in DaVinci Resolve. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit subscribe so you won't miss the upcoming video. In the upcoming video, I'll guide you through the process of developing interactive furniture replacement mechanics with customizable options, using my project as a hands-on example. We will be crafting an animated interface and integrating a convenient feature allowing instant transitions from the project to an online store for each selected option. See you in the next project!